Yo, Habibi, legit, you look mad possessed. Oh, are they Niqabi sisters? They look like Niqabi strippers. Yo, why is this hijabi sister wearing a grill, bro? This makes no sense.
Way of life as cute, keeping it 100.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video, as you can see, is going to be about that controversial new album cover from French Montana. Before we proceed with this video, I need you to smash this video with a huge thumbs up, and I need you to subscribe to this channel as well. Guys, we got a lot of stuff to talk about, so let's just jump into this video. Recently, Muslim Moroccan rapper...
Moroccan? I thought he was French.
French Montana released the picture and a video of his new album cover. The album cover, as you have seen, involves him surrounded on his right and on his left with full Niqabi women with thigh-high red kinky boots.
We have seen the evidence.
Now, immediately, I just want to know your thoughts upon seeing this cover in the comment section below. I just want you to jump down there and just tell me what your thoughts are overall when you first saw this album cover. Naturally, there's some mixed thoughts about this album cover, with majority of the Muslims saying that this is just inappropriate. But you will hear every now and then that one Muslim who says,
if a Christian had some nuns, would they get upset?
Listen, bro, I don't give a damn what a Christian does between them and their religion. They've made a joke of their own God allowing people to draw them. So I wouldn't be surprised if, in fact, a rapper did use Christian religious symbolism on their rap covers and people don't even bat an eyelid. If they don't react in a negative way, that's their choice. We need to maintain our own standards and not compare ourselves to others. Upon dropping the album cover for his third studio album, French Montana tweets, "You don't have to change who you are. You can welcome people into your own world." I got a question for French Montana and anyone else who thinks that this is okay. In what world does a Niqabi wear red thigh-high kinky boots? Tell me, which world is that, French?
Brother, that's a very good question.
Some even joked around and thought that he was just promoting all of his wives.
French messed up. We're only allowed four. He has too many.
But you see, I can also understand from one perspective in which he is trying to promote Islam and make it a little more mainstream. So his intentions might be that he's trying to diversify and show his tradition and his culture on a rap album, which hasn't really been done before. But what he's failing to realize is that he's sexualizing Islam, especially with Niqabi, which doesn't deserve any type of sexualization. It's actually perverting Islam. French's message has nothing to do with Islam. It doesn't promote Islam. In fact, it goes against everything that Islam teaches. Yet, you're using Islam for marketing purposes and to use this controversy to make your album a little more relevant.
Profiting from Islam, and he's profiting from Muslims.
What you don't realize, bro, is that you're making these women look like some Muslim strippers. The fact that you guys watching this right now cringe when I use the word strippers and Islam in the same sentence shows the fact how pure Islam is, and anytime someone tries to contaminate it, it doesn't work out. You're saying that you can be modest and a freak at the same time.
Halal in the sheets, freak in the streets, am I right? Okay, that was a bad joke.
Delete this before I make dua to Allah to make sure you lose your voice.
Bro, you're promoting this half-deen, half-dunya type of lifestyle, and that's a recipe that just doesn't mix.
All right, we're gonna check out this new recipe for some deen over dunya biryani. First, we're gonna need some dunya. Get a large bit of that dunya, because we're gonna need it. Give generously, you already know. We're gonna need some deen masala, all right? We're gonna get that Shan Deen masala. Just put the whole damn thing in there. But we also need some alcohol. It's all right, because you drink on the weekend, it's cool. But wait, oh, sorry. With the right hand for barakah, left is for the shaitan. You already know. Okay, we're gonna need some salah, but you don't need that much of it, because your heart is what really matters. Just a little pinch of it, just a little dab, a dash, that's it, we're good. Now, we're gonna need some weed. It's cool, it opens your mind up, and it's all right, because it's a plant, it's from the earth, it's good for you, it's fine. Ooh, that's that good stuff right there. Now we're gonna need some Quran, but not that much of it, just a little dash of it. Boom. All right, now, last but not least, Ramadan is gonna fix it all. We do all this haram stuff, Ramadan is gonna cleanse us up, and now we're ready for that biryani.
You're promoting this idea that you could still be you and do you, even if it doesn't align with Islam. Why? Because what matters is what's really in your heart. Bro, we've heard that before. That's essentially misguidance and a false narrative that you have zero justification for.
So give us some governmental documents.
And if you continue to act this way, bro, on the Day of Judgment, you're not going to be known as French Montana. You're going to be known as French Toast. People will support you and lead you on to think you're doing some amazing, liberating thing. But the truth is that they don't understand your religion. And I don't know if you understand your religion as well. And if you don't have the right people in your circle of friends, they're going to lead you astray. And sometimes there might not be any coming back. As Muslims, we have the right to be offended. And no one could take that away from us. Not even Muslims themselves. And the honest truth is that as Muslims, we have ghira over our deen, bro. Like, we're really protective about our deen. We have jealousy within our deen because we love it so much. And the moment we give up that right is the moment we become open season for people to play around with our beliefs. But I also don't want to front and act like he's done no good. With the tons of charity that he gives and the people he supports back home in Morocco, no one can deny what he's actually doing as far as what is good. Islamic type garments at the Met Gala is a pretty big deal. Him posting about himself at the masjid in the month of Ramadan on his own Instagram page is something that the average Muslim rapper doesn't really do. The fact that he's representing his culture and what he believes to be Islam on a massive stage, I think that's a pretty cool thing. When I see French Montana, I see a really good dude with great intention, just not the right guidance. He has his foot in both worlds and he's trying to be the best of both worlds. But you could either turn your back to Allah and face the people, or turn your back to the people and face Allah. The choice is yours, bro. Well, that was the video, guys. I appreciate you watching so much. Tell me in the comment section below, what was your thoughts about this? And what was perhaps one of your major takeaways? And what advice would you like to give friends in case he were to watch this YouTube video?
Tell me in the comment section below.
If you benefit from this video, I need you to smash this video with a huge thumbs up. And I need you to subscribe to this channel as well. And until next time, I'm out.